Watch out, Gladys. Watch out. I'm trying to get over here. Gladys, get out of the picture. Can't you see what I'm trying to do here? Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Ark Survival Evolved. This is Scoops right here, and over here, it's Leroy. And I tell you, these two guys, they're full of crap. Welcome back to the episode of Ark Survival Evolved. I am the Radio Man 03, and it is great to have you along. Let's take care of something real quick here. There we go. Let me take that off so I can see ya. I can see you with my own two eyes. That is Scoops and Leroy. They are awesome. The backspace button. Leroy. He's full of... Oh, he is not full of poop anymore. He's full of fertilizer and oil. Take a look at that, huh? How awesome is that? What do you got on you, Scoops? Scoops, come here. Come here now. Don't go running away. Not that he can get very far. Oh my gosh, look at all that stuff. Look at all that. Oh my gosh, what a way to start the day. Battle music. Gladys in the way. Leroy. And Scoops, full of... yeah, that's right. You stand at attention when I come by. Did you see those guys lift out of the ground? Let's go. Let's get Rose. Let's go see what happened. We'll come back to Leroy and Scoops in just a second. Our Dung Beetles. Hope everyone's doing great. I am having a fantastic day today. It is my Thursday. It's my longer day at work, but I'd be darned if I'm not going to get a video out to you. Good job, Plant Species X. Quality job on your part. Scoops and Leroy. As you saw in the last episode, we got those down in the cave of with the artifact of the hunter in it. Hopefully we'll go look at the artifact of the hunter in just a second. These guys are amazing. If you don't have any, you need to go get yourself some. Now, I want you to look at something real quick. Their weight. Okay, he can hold 7 pounds. Right now, he has 0.6 pounds. Just a little over half a pound of poop on him. This guy right here, Scoops, he can hold up to 7 pounds as well. And he has, like, 0 poundage of poop. Oh, that's right. We took one off of him, didn't we? We've got one in our inventory. Boop. There we go. So he's got 0.3 pounds as well. Now, these guys want to be full of poop. They just want to be full of poop. So let's go out in the yard. Anybody in here got some poop for me? Poop? Anybody got poop? Oh. There's a little dodo poop. Okay, let's go out in the yard. I'm willing to bet we've got some decent-sized poops out here. You guys don't have any poop up there either. Wow, no one's got any poop for me. What the heck? Ah, Wilbur. You know, Wilbur. He took it right back. You can't have it, Radio. I'm sick and tired of you taking my poop. Can't have it. Let's take, Demence poop. Ah, Olivia Oil has a poop. Ooh, a big one. From Alpha Ghost. Lovely, lovely. Anybody else? There is something we need to talk about when it comes to the beetles. They like to be absolutely 100% full. Wilbur's got another one out here already. Look at this guy. He just gave it back. Give it back, Wilbur. All right, let's go inside and see if we've got enough poop to make these guys happy. Oh, there's a couple more. We need these guys. Sorry. Excuse me. Thank you. All right, let's go inside. Come on now. Hey, I want to say quickly thank you to and welcome to the new subscribers. Great to have you along. Thank you for all the channel support. You guys have been fantastic. Lots of great comments and all that good stuff going on. It's always a lot of fun when that happens. All right, let's go in down here. Let's see how much poop this guy could take. T. Oh, I'm putting fertilizer back in him. I'm looking down here. 3.6. Okay, that's too much. That's too heavy. We can put a 1.5 on there. Now he's got 5.1. He's got 6.6. And he can't take 1.5. No, okay. 6.6 pounds of poop on him right now. So we need a couple of little poops is what we need in order to finish filling him up. If you have your dung beetles full, they will produce the fertilizer and the oil faster is what I've noticed. Oh, boy, that's a good one right there. That's a dandy if I've ever seen one. There's another one. Quick. The poop race is on. Okay, let's go to Leroy here and check him out. Leroy, they have to be on wandering, okay? You have to have them on wandering in order for this to work. Oh my gosh, he's already made some more. Look at him. He can't wait to get that stuff out of him. All right, now he's up to 5.5 pounds, so he can't take this one. It's too big, and yeah, he's not going to take that one. It's too big as well. So we need some little ones. How about us? Yep, there we go. There's one. There's a little one. There's a little poop. And we take that, and we slide it on in there. He can take that. Now he's at 5.6 pounds. The point is, if you have more on him, look how slow Scoops is going now, because he's almost filled up. The more you have on them, the faster they're going to turn that waste into fertilizer and oil for you. And the fertilizer, I don't know if you guys ever noticed this, but fertilizer has no expiration date on it, which is really great. If you go to the poop, poop does. It spoils here in 2 hours and 44 minutes on my inventory. You put it in the plants, it'll last a little bit longer. Gladys, do you have any poop there? Oh, look at that. You saw it, ladies and gentlemen. She does not want to give up poop. She wants to give up eggs. Gladys has been doing that. She's been laying eggs all over the place on the floor. Little poop. Got it. Come on, come on, come on. Don't let me lose it. Buckley, how about you, buddy? No? Don't feel like pooping for me? Okay. Let's go back over to Scoops. I think we had him almost filled up. Let's see. 0.3 pounds. Okay, so 6.9 to 7 pounds. There is no smaller poops except the one that comes out of me. That's a 0.1, so we could add that to it. But he's going to turn that into fertilizer really fast now. So make sure you keep your dung beetles nice and full of waste, okay? And that's going to help out a lot. A lot of poop really helps a lot. So we need a couple more pounds of poop here, guys. Who's gonna choke it up for me? Who's going to cough them out? There we go. There we go. One there. Anybody? Anybody else? Little poops? Looking for some little poops? Nancy Narcotic. I don't think I've ever seen her poop. She's got a level. We've been putting movement speed on her. We continue to put movement speed on her because she's so dang slow. Leroy, where'd you go? There you are, buddy. All right, so Leroy, we got one more for you, buddy. Like so. 5.9, so he can take about a pound more poop. One more pound. We just need one more little poop. That's it. I don't know if I'm going to... There we go. There we go. There we go. That's it. That's the one we needed right there. And Leroy, I think you should be filled up by now. And survey says 6.2. That's pretty good. He's almost full. So we're going to go with that. And these guys both, you can see they can barely move now when they've got all that on them. So they're going to turn that into fertilizer real fast. We're going to leave them alone. And we're going to move on to something else. Yesterday, it would have been February 10th, I was trying to get a decent open and close put on the video that I put out regarding the cave that we went into. And I started recording, and nothing showed up on the video except for the sound of me and the game sound. But the picture was black, and it was because of the battle eye that was put on to the game. The anti-cheat and hack, that thing really screws up OBS. So if you're a recorder, you're going to want to remove that as fast as you can. I don't know why I said yes to it, because of the fact that I don't need it. I'm on a private server, so I don't have to worry about hacking and people cheating and stuff like that. All right, wow, look at this. We're going to be able to change all this over to fertilizer, and we're going to be good to go for a very, very long time up here. Oh, these guys are already stocked full of fertilizer. This is great. So, yeah, oh, there was a piece of poop in there. Let's get rid of that. We're going to dump that in there like so. All right. There's a bunch of stuff I need to cover today, and maybe what I should do is finish doing the poop thing here off camera. We're almost there, though, ladies and gentlemen, so just hang with me. This is what we wanted to do. This is the beautiful thing we're doing right here, because we're getting so much stuff. I'll come back and get this stuff and turn it into narcotics and everything else later. But this is what farming gets you, just a ton of material and supplies, so it's absolutely fantastic. All right, good deal. Everybody's got what they need here. Let's go downstairs. Let's go out here to the dock. Let's make sure there's no sarcos in the water. Sarcos. Oh, sarcos. You're going to notice that little platform out there. We're going to go out there and take a look at that today, too. All right, so I've been messing around with greenhouse stuff. Now, if you look at the plants... Oh, by the way, I moved the long grass plant that was down here. I've moved it up into this area here. So now we've got a bit of a greenhouse going on here. No roof on it yet, and the walls aren't finished because I ran out of crystal and I ran out of time getting that material yesterday as I was trying to figure out why all of a sudden I could not record on OBS. Now that I've got it figured out, I'm in good shape. These are all doing great. Now, if you look down here at the bottom, it says greenhouse effect 0%. Despite the fact I have all these glass walls around here, I get no greenhouse effect on this at all. And I think what's going to happen is once I put the ceiling on, that's when it's going to happen. And this greenhouse effect should go all the way up to 300%. Okay? That's the most you can get out of it is 300%. That's going to make the fertilizer last longer, and it's going to make the plants grow a lot more food. So that is a project that I am working on, and we'll probably finish that up in the next episode together because it's going to take me quite a bit of time to go get the crystal and stuff like that. So I wanted to show you that. And over here, ladies and gentlemen, please, come over here. Come over here with myself and Rose Red. I've installed three of these guys right here. These are our little, what the heck? Come on, get on that ladder, boy. There you go. These are our plant species X crop plots. Let's go in here. We're going to drop a seed in there. We're going to drop, 1, 2, 3. Let's do that. And a 1, 2. We'll throw some of those poops in there. And bam, we got ourselves a nice plant species X out here. I figured if a Sarco comes up through this area, this will start shooting at him and give me a heads up because I'll get that music and good stuff like that coming on. So, we've got one there. Near, 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 flying through the air on Rose Red. Lovely. And we have one right here as well. I was looking back at some of the old episodes, and I talked about doing this a long time ago, about having some of these by the gates for added protection for the base. And so here we are, ladies and gentlemen. We are doing it. We are getting them put together. 2, and then 1, 2, 3. We'll do that right there. Those guys are going to have more fertilizer for me. Aren't those beautiful? Look at those. Those are some beautiful plants. Just beautiful plants. I really love how they look. They're amazing. Fertilizer. I don't know that the fertilizer goes away. Plant species X across the side of the building there that look out over that large area, they all have as much fertilizer as they had when I first installed them and put fertilizer in them. They don't have any regular raw poop in them. They have just the fertilizer. So I don't know that fertilizer goes away, which is kind of a cool thing if you think about it. Saves you a lot of time. I don't know if that's a bug or what it is, but, you know, there we go. So, we have plant species X. Not, what do you mean not irrigated? It's 600 out of 600. How could you say it's not irrigated? Do you see that? Blue letters. Not irrigated, yet it says it's 600 over 600. And it says there's a seedling in there. Oh, well, I don't know. That one had a plant on it. I can't remember if the first one had a plant or not in it when we finished seeding it. Did it? Did it? Did it, ladies and gentlemen? Did it have a plant? I don't know. I don't know. A couple of new things came out of the game this week, and that's another thing I wanted to show you guys this week, and we're going to take care of it today. I'm a little bit behind the eight ball on it, but what the heck? I'm going to show you anyway. So we're going over here to see if there's a plant on this, actually. No, this one didn't show a plant either, but this one here did. I wonder why that is. See, you can see the plant in there. Oh, well, okay. Whatever. Whatever. Let's go on inside. Variety 3 was in here yesterday and made up a few things for me. Oh, first of all, let me show you this. This is the artifact of the hunter. Isn't it beautiful? Oh, by the way, that's the artifact of the clever, not the artifact of the cleaver, as I said. Scheisse. Crazy, right? Artifact of the hunter? Yes. On the south shore. Excellent. Okay, so we've got two of these now. I think they're really cool. At night, they glow beautifully up here. They look really, really nice. All right, let's get Rose Red on down here. We'll plant her right here in this walkway. And we're going to head over here because we've got some new stuff to look at. The grappling hook. Uh-huh. Variety said she put them right in here. We're going to drop the oil in there as well. We're going to dump this rotten old nasty meat off of us. And there's our saddle for the terror bird, which we're going to go out and get today. And she made us up 16 grappling hooks because she is spectacular. All right, so did that load that up on there? It looks like I still have arrows on there. There it goes. Okay. Grabbed it that time. It's 12 noon, ladies and gentlemen. 12 noon. Now, I'm supposed to be able to grapple on up onto things with this guy. If you make the grapple hooks, it shows you what you can and can't do with it. Excuse me, guys. Boom. All right. Oh, left click. Oh, baby, look at that. That is so cool, huh? Okay, am I in? Am I in here? Oh, okay, so I right-clicked again. Oh, that is so cool. Look at that. Then right-click is down. Okay, left click is to draw yourself in. Right click is to let yourself down. Oh, baby, look at that. Oh, that is awesome. Okay, so now you're supposed to be able to, I believe. No, it doesn't want to give me any. Okay, how do I make it break loose? No. Let's see if I take it off my inventory. It's still there. Oh my gosh, that is really awesome. Look at that. So So as you're going up, if you hit the jump button as you're grappling upwards, it's supposed to let you hop up. All right, how do I detach from this thing? I don't want it anymore. Let's put the torch on. Take the torch off. Okay, I guess it's gone. Oh, it's not gone. It's not gone. I'm still attached to this thing. I don't know how to get it out. Come on, let go. Let go of it. Oh, that's crazy. Let's see if I go... If I take these and put them in here. Okay, now it's let me... It's still attached to me. What the heck is going on? Oops. All right. Let me figure this out. Oh. Okay. So I shot it. When I jumped, it looks like it detached it. Okay, so that's interesting. I'm not quite sure exactly still how I did that, but that's how I broke it loose. You saw that there. Now, from what I understand, is we can actually... Oh my God, I'm wasting these things. Oh man, I'm wasting them. Let's see. If we take... and fly one of these guys up into the air a little ways, we're supposed to be able to grapple hook to them. This is going to hurt a little bit, but I'm willing to do it for science. Oh, that's okay. I'm okay. I'm okay, guys. I'm okay. Oh, my gosh. I'm not okay. That hurt really bad. Okay, we're getting our health back. So if I shoot Rust Bucket... Oh, yeah. There we go. And I'm on. Look at that. Okay, sweet. Okay, so that's kind of nice. You know, you could put your bird up someplace high so it doesn't take any damage while you're on the ground doing something. And if you need to, you could just put yourself up and you could zip yourself back up to the bird and not have to worry about anything coming after you. Little raptor, you're too far away. Let's drop you back over here. That's right. Rust Bucket, baby. Rust Bucket. Okay, now you're also supposed to use these on cliffs. So maybe we can go over here on the other side of this rock and see if we can't get up on this rock here. I'm freezing. It's so dang cold out here. Oh, there's a saber over there, another saber over there. Ooh, we've got raptors all over the place over there, too. I think we're okay here. I think we're going to be okay. What do you want anyways, buddy? Will you protect me if anything comes? Yes, you will. You're on neutral. Okay, excellent. All right, let's go. Oh, yeah, look at that. And then you launch yourself forward. Okay, that's what it is. I wasn't doing it fast enough. When you shoot something with the left trigger, shoot left click, okay, we're going to draw ourselves in. Oh, man. And then if you hit the jump, it launches you up. Oh boy, look at that. Did you see that? I just saved myself from falling all the way down like that. Oh, back on the ground. Oh, that is so cool, guys. That is so cool. It looks like you have to go all the way up and hit the jump button and then boom. Oh God, that hurt. I'm almost dead again. Oh, that really hurt bad. My heart's beating really hard. I can't even eat food right now. That's okay. We're inside the base. We're clear. Okay, so yeah, cliffs, rocks. Looks like the base. We can go ahead and, you know, do the base and thing. We can shoot up to the base and land on the platform up there. I'm not going to do it right now because I think it would actually kill me, and I don't want to die. That's not the goal here today. But the grappling hook. What an awesome thing to do. Now I'm think you can actually attach to these other birds, right? As he says he doesn't want to die. Let's see if this guy will stick around for a little bit. Yeah, that's it. Oh, you're beautiful, too. Look how orange you are. What are you? You're level 26. You're actually a pretty good bird, too, for our server. All right, the food is taking forever. Let's go see if we've got a health tonic. We'll take a couple of those health tonics and see if that'll fix us up here real quick. So we can actually... I'd like to latch onto him and see if it doesn't help. All right, so... Health. Oh, look at that. That's bumping the old health up real quick, isn't it? 104. Oh, that's doing really actually a very good deal. Oh, that's nice. Okay, that works better than I thought it did. Down in the cave, it didn't seem like it was having any effect on me at all. But apparently it does. Okay, where'd that pteranodon go so we can experiment with this a little bit? Oh, there it is. There it is. There it is. Oh my gosh, he landed right up there. Let's see. Oh, come on. Oh, I got him. I got him. Yeehaw! Fishing for pteranodon. No! Don't take me out! No, don't take me out there! No! Oh gosh! That's right. You kill whatever's out there. Okay, so I detached. Maybe it's because the bird got too far away. I finally detached from it. Well, we should probably have our sword out just in case something bad comes running up on us and we got to defend ourselves. Oh, that was cool. Okay, so you can latch on to the birds that are not tamed as well, which is very cool. Okay, the only thing I don't know is can we attach ourselves to a tree? That probably is not going to be a possibility. Because I was thinking, you know, if you get in danger down in the jungle, you could possibly hook yourself up into a tree and get out of the way. Yeah, no, it did not hook onto the tree. Okay, all right, good enough. Good enough. That is really a cool addition to the game. Very cool addition to the game. Now, the next thing we are going to do, ladies and gentlemen, is we are going to go out and find ourselves a terror bird. We are going to tame said terror bird, and then we are going to ride the terror bird. So I will be right back when I'm ready to go. Welcome back. It is now Friday afternoon. I started recording this episode Thursday afternoon, and unfortunately, I hate to report it, I have not been able to find the terror bird. I flew all over the island, all over the beaches, all the way around it, up and down the rivers, up by the mountains, and the only thing I can think of is I need to kill a lot more dinosaurs in order to get the terror bird to go ahead and spawn in. So what I will do is I will work towards that and see if we can get some terror birds spawned in, and then I will bring another episode where we talk about the terror birds and get them on some camera. But I've spent several hours now looking for them, and I have not been able to locate them. We have the saddle, so we're good to go there. Real quick, something else I've noticed since the last time when I started recording this episode, if you look on the grapple hook itself, it tells you exactly how to use this, and I did not notice this when I started recording this video. Primary fire to reel in is your left click. Secondary fire to reel out. Crouch is what you use the crouch button C to detach from the grappling hook. Jump and reel in to vault and jump. That's just, you know, that's simple. You space bar and then you're reeling in, and boom, you get shot up into the area that you're hopefully grappling up to. So there is that. Let's see, what else did I want to show? Oh, something else I wanted to show you guys real quick. While we were out on Rust Bucket, I did manage to pick up a bunch of these seedlings, and I thought we'd real quick, before we call it an episode today, see if these are going to give our plants that greenhouse effect by putting some seedlings on. So I did pick up a bunch of crystal. It's not nearly enough for what we have left to do. I've still got several walls that need to be put up here. I think I've got like 8 or 9 walls left and then the ceilings above that. But let's go ahead and see if we can put some of these ceilings on and start to get some of this greenhouse effect working. I'm thinking it's probably going to work once we do this. The only reason I went too high with the walls is because we do have the water taps there. All right, let's take a look and see. Oh, wow, 300% already. Oh, wow. Okay, just by putting the ceilings up, it jumped considerably. Okay, just for those though, right there, look at that. These still have a zero greenhouse effect. Let's see what happens with this. 300% greenhouse effect already with just that one put in. So as long as you have this right over the plant, it looks like, you get your greenhouse effect. 300%, bam, just like that. That's pretty cool. Makes it so I guess you really don't need the walls. If you've got the plants and some other kind of structure, you could just put the glass ceilings on maybe and get the same effect. I don't know. We'll have to see. We'll have to see somewhere down the road if that's the case. But yeah, there we go. Can we see this one turn? 300%. There it is. Okay, so that's the key. That looks pretty good, too. I love the fact that we've got glass coming in on Arc. It's really going to add a lot of different options for us while we're building, I think. A whole lot of different options. That had kind of a weird little look to it there, didn't it? We're back in here. It doesn't seem to be doing it now. It looked like it was almost split in two by the glass somehow. But yeah, that's... okay, greenhouse effect, 300%. That's the key, is to get those ceilings put on. Let's go up and take a look at it from up here real fast. Sorry I could not get the Terror Bird on. I'm really sorry about that. I will work on it very hard over the weekend. It is a Friday right now, so I'm going to get this video uploaded because I missed two videos this week, and I feel bad about that already. So I'm going to get this video posted. We'll find a Terror Bird. We'll get that tamed up, and we also need to... breed our trikes and get that video posted as well. So I've got lots of work to do this weekend, a lot of fun kind of work to do this weekend. But there's the start of our greenhouse in the dock. I think it looks pretty good. It's, you know, it's just a box, it's a square, but with the plants inside, I think it looks pretty cool, and I love the fact that there is glass now. So guys, I think that is going to wrap up the episode. I want to thank you so much for your time, as always. Like, comment, subscribe, and share if you see fit. I'm the Radio Man 03, and I will talk to you again next time. Bye-bye.